So I really just wanted to do a video because when stuff hits me pretty hard, I like to talk and instead of typing, it really doesn't, I can't express myself in the best way when I type. So this death hasn't really sunk in yet. I think I'm still a little bit in shock. But this one hit, Chadwick's hit hard, because I spent a little bit of time around Chadwick in the end stages of casting for Black Panther. I was flying back and forth while I was doing Descendants, testing with him for the role that Letitia Wright ended up getting, who I love. I think she's incredible. But we didn't just test, like Ryan put us in a room and was like, talk, and left. And it was just the two of us and we just talked. And I immediately fell in love with that dude. Immediately. And that's not usual for me. I don't like most people I meet, especially in this industry. But the thing that stood out to me the most about him was the level of comfort that he had in himself and in who he was and his purpose that God put in him. Outside of men in my own family, like I know like the back of my hand, like my dad, my brother, I've never been around somebody that is that comfortable in themselves. And it's just like, take it or leave it. And that level of comfort can be almost intimidating, because it's like, because there's no arrogance in it. Arrogance doesn't intimidate me. I know how to deal with arrogant people. There wasn't an inch of arrogance in that man's body. He was just comfortable. And I'm still young, I just hit 22. But that level, that comfort is something that I'm trying to get to. I'm pretty comfortable with myself, but what he had, I'm gonna start living more like that. I'm gonna start living more like that. I don't care how anybody feels about it. I'm gonna be comfortable with who I am and with my purpose. There's just not a lot of people that were like him anymore on this earth. Like, he was of old. He really was. And when I saw him, not even a year ago, we did a panel together. I did a panel with him and two other creators in the industry. And when I saw him after Black Panther came out, after it did everything it did, he was still the same dude, like the exact same dude. And he says some things to me I'm never gonna forget. I'm gonna keep our last interaction to myself, because I remember the last thing he said to me. And I remember the last thing I said to him. But he imparted a lot of wisdom. A lot of wisdom on me, and I'm sure on all of us. But he was also really responsible with the way that he carried himself, with the way he spoke, with the projects that he got behind and put together and was a part of. He carried himself like a king. He did. And we could all learn something from that. He treated this like it was a responsibility, because it is. It is. I can't keep talking. I gotta get off soon, because like I said, this still hasn't hit me yet, and I was hoping it wouldn't hit me while I was doing this video, but we just losing a lot of good people. We're really losing a lot of good people, and it hurts. It's starting to feel pretty lonely down here. But anyway, we can learn something from Chadwick. And you need to look in the mirror and see what it is that you're supposed to be doing down here. Whatever your purpose is, whatever you were put down here to do, just do it. Just do it, and do it until the wheels fall off. Do it till you can't do it anymore. Because if you're not doing that, then what are you doing? You know? And do it responsibly too. Because we have too much darkness in the world already. We've already got a lot of smut and dirt in this world. Please be responsible. He was very responsible. He taught a lot of us a lot of things. This is a blow to everybody. It's a big blow to the black community. I mean, we lost a brother, for real. He kicked open doors for us. Just kicked them open. And they gonna stay open because of him. He opened doors for us, guys. We were lucky to be living in the